Well, your foundation, what you've done, is just terrific. You have done a great job. You really have.
Thank you.
And I think we're very proud of what you've done. What I'm proud of is that the Chinese Cultural Foundation has done a great deal to have Americans know more about China. And that's been very important. You've done a good job.
Oh, because your inspiration and your leadership.
Well, I don't know about that.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
I'm very proud to be here at the 15th anniversary of the Chinese Cultural Foundation. When we started the foundation, we had little idea that it could expand and be so important in terms of the future of the world.
We're not only interested in business and politics and education, we're interested in cultural affairs. We work with major organizations like Juilliard, Carnegie Hall. One of our members, who's the head of the Chinese Cultural Foundation.
The cultural exchange is so important for the people to understand each other's nation and culture.
It was Jim Wolfensohn, who was head of the World Bank, that made the best comment about the importance of culture at our 10th anniversary gala. He said that all the elements of culture really transcend natural boundaries. That beauty knows no boundaries, knows no national boundaries. Our initial mission looked back. We wanted to present the 5,000 or more years of Chinese history and culture to the world. As I think back over the history of the Chinese Cultural Foundation, I can remember several very, very exciting moments. One was at the Palace of Versailles in Paris, France, at the world's first cultural exhibition. Elizabeth Wang was there with some of the great Chinese artists, and also representing the importance of Chinese culture to the European as well as the world community. Another very inspiring moment was at the World Economic Forum celebration at the Great Hall of the People in Beijing. And there, the Chinese Cultural Foundation not only hosted a gala dinner, but also showed a number of very important paintings, Chinese contemporary art, as well as the collection of the rare birds of China. And then I remember one particular fun event hosted at the Citibank, at Citicorp. And the founder of the Tiger Tones, the singing group from Princeton, brought the Tiger Tones to the event at the Citicorp. And it was a very fun event. We all enjoyed it, and we celebrated culture not only in Princeton, but throughout the world.
Chinese Cultural Foundation, 15 years old. For all these years, full of challenge and a proud achievement. It has been a perfect preparation for the Maurice R. Greenberg Global Leadership Award.
Well, firstly, I just wanted to say a huge congratulations to the Chinese Cultural Foundation on the 15th anniversary. I think you're a really important organization. I was very honored to receive your award in 2014. I think it's wonderful that Mr. Greenberg has actually agreed on this occasion of the 15th anniversary to have the Maurice R. Greenberg Global Leadership Award named in his honor, because I think for anybody receiving it, this will be an extraordinary achievement.
Congratulations to the Chinese Cultural Foundation for its 15th anniversary. And on this occasion, I also would like to congratulate this organization for the announcement of the Maurice R. Greenberg Global Leadership Award.